Alrighty, so we're going to be wiring a bedroom here, and I want to show you something really nice to see. We're using some south wire wire here, and guess what? It's made here in the country I was born in. You can see the flag here. It's upside down. And there it is right there. That's a great thing to see. Okay, so we have our template to mount the ad-libs up. We'll make a mark here. And we'll make a mark here. This is called a spade bit here. It's a little bit harder than the auger bit, but we don't have the auger bit today, so we're just doing it with the spade. Shorter runs aren't that bad because it doesn't get twisted up too bad. We can mount our box. It says the half inch mark here, so I'll put it right on the back the rest of the way so I can feel that half inch mark there. Make sure it's flush here. wires. We'll start with our ground wires here. The crimp in the crimp sleeve like that. Squeeze it nice and tight. That saves an extra wire nut in the box too. Makes folding the wires a lot easier too. Put them so even here. Third one in. Okay, so we'll close the screws we're not going to use here. But we need to hook up under the pressure plates here. I'll hold it up, make sure it's going to be long enough. That one is. And that one is. So we'll put our ground wire on the green screw. Make sure the insulation doesn't get under the pressure plate there. Nice and tight. Insulation's not under the pressure plate. Turn around here. Get our black on the brass screw here. Okay, that was slightly long, so I'll just take a tiny little smidgen off, just a very tiny smidgen. Now we're down to our next one here. When I'm done, I'll come back with the camera and show you up close all of them. So this box, we're going to be hooking in three wires, three 12-2s, and see how this box is deeper, so it has more room. So I have to use a deeper box here. Turn the light so you can see better. Whatever falls out, let it lay. I don't care. Okay. Make sure all the debris is off of there. All right. So how'd you make out?
Good.
So I think I'll be ready to eat in probably about an hour or so.
Okay.
Because that, by that time, I'll have the bedroom all done.
Sounds good.
Making sure those wires aren't pinched there, so we're good. Oh, I never found the other bit, no.
Can I saw?
Yes, go ahead and saw, yeah. I have the cord I needed for the drill.
Still need it?
No, I'm all... Well, I am going to need it once I get over to the...
I'll give it back.
TV, okay.
I'll cut a bunch and then give it back.
Okay. Now, this one I'm going to have to wire nut the ground wires because there's too many for the crimp sleeve. Once it starts crooked, you don't want to straighten it. little longer. Flip it even with the shortest one here. Make sure all four are even. Now put my wire nut on here. I'm going to hold this tail to keep it from unwinding and getting uneven inside the spring, so I'm going to. Oh, do you want to drill a few holes just like across the top of the door?
Not with this one.
It's too big.
What do you want?
Like across the top of the door so I can come down and put that outlet over there. Yep, right there, yep.
Okay. Bringing that fourth one just a little trickier. Getting in there nice and even. I'll cut it so all the wires are even on the end here. Hook up to the outlet. These green screws don't take a Phillips screwdriver very good. I don't know why, but they're crappy with the Phillips, so I'll tighten with the other one. So I'm going to close the one we're not going to be using here. sure the insulation's not going to get under the pressure plate. Make sure it's nice and tight. And I'll close the one that I'm going to be using here. Take a very little tiny swing off this one. Did you find the bit?
Yes.
Where was it?
I didn't find that bit, no. I found two different shorter bits.
Oh. It's something how it disappeared, isn't it?
Well, very weird.
Because I've had keys to my house and I locked them. And they were gone the next morning, and I couldn't find them anywhere. I had to go to Lowe's, leave my house unlocked.
Did you ever find them?
No, never found them. Alrighty, so there we go. So there we are on that one. Oh, it came out a little bit, so I'm going to loosen this up a little bit. Push it in. Whoa, a little long. I take a very tiny smidgen. That out so you can see it at the end. Okay, I'm going to have to drill a few holes over here.
I'm going to right there.
Oh, okay.
Find the drill. Okay.
Okay, so I'm going to make juncture in the corner to get the wire into this corner here. Thank you.
You know what one of the worst things is? One thing I really hate a lot?
What's that?
Spending, forgetting where I put stuff and spending a lot of time looking for it. Do you hate that too?
Yep.
So I put the wire up there to go over to the other one.
Make sure your stone's fast.
Another thing is, don't fight with a staple. The staple is going to win, you're not going to win. So if it bends, just leave it loose. Because otherwise you'll pinch the wire and mash it inside. So either pull it out or just leave it. That's a good idea, isn't it?
Yep.
Find the drill bit yet? You know what, when that happens to me, instead of getting frustrated, I'll just go buy another one, you know? Quite a bit.
That's why they call it a bit. Because it comes quite a bit.
That's a pretty good one, yeah. I'd rather have a death over my head than a frustration, you know?
Mm-hmm.
That 2x2 idea is going to work good?
Well, I got these metal plates going over it.
Oh, okay, yeah. What did you get for metal plates?
Tools.
Oh, good. Okay, here in the country I was born in, the black wire is live and the white is neutral.
looking for? Oh. Bring the camera down so you can see it up close. Close the screws I'm not using. Okay, so we're gonna put our last outlet up here. Thank you. actually another way to do these ground wire crimp sleeves. So I'm gonna slip my end here, slip my end here. Okay, so another way you can do this is you can take your two ground wires here, you can twist them like this. Okay, you can clip your shorter one shorter here, grab them here, twist them. Squeeze it nice and tight. And I'll leave a nice tail here. Then we'll pigtail our blacks and whites together. Get our white wires together here. Get the insulation lined up here on the bottom. Our twist. So it's even. And the crimp on the ground wire. Thank you. gonna push our wires back into the box here. Now this out, I'm going to put the wires around the screws. Always put the wire around the screw the direction that the screw turns. Okay, just about 2 more minutes. I just got to put the last wire on this and I'll be ready. Well, that messed up nice. Oh, come on. Okay. So I'm gonna open this loop up, make it a little bit bigger. Direction of the screw turns. Okay, it's nice and tight. Okay, I'm just going to close these two screws off here. I'll bring the camera over so you can see it. Alrighty, so that's how we wire outlets here in the country I was born in.